You must be ginger.
This week in the first of a brand new series of The Gadget Show.
Now, I'd like to cast your minds back to last October, which I'm sure most British people, you know, if they're honest, remember as a month of significant scientific innovation. It was, of course, the time when I created and tested my water-powered rocket dragster.
That is a car powered completely by pressurised water rockets.
Almost up 30, he's got to go! I absorbed all of it in my sock!
Oh, man.
This is snorted.
Fantastic.
It wasn't fantastic.
Fantastically bad. Fantastically bad. But you know what? We didn't give up. We asked you, the Gadget Show viewers, to send in your ideas for how we could improve it. And I was bowled over by the response. Thousands of emails is what we received. Look, I'll just show you a mere handful of some of them. We had people quoting Newton's third law. We had people with PhD after their name, people that head up science departments for the government, emailing us, telling us what we should do, and essentially it boiled down to the following. We needed more water under more pressure and a much simpler assembly. So your hard work has led to what we're calling water-powered rocket dragster version 2.0.
Our new design is all about power.
We've dumped the water coolers and we've gone with two beer kegs. These are made of stainless steel, which means they're incredibly strong and can hold up to 3.5 times the pressure of the previous version of the water-powered dragster. OK, so that's the techie bit. Coming out of the sexy shot of me in leathers looking all cool. Great. Now let's test this bad boy.
Once we're pressurised, I'll release the water from the first keg to propel me off the line, and then release the other one once I'm moving for extra thrust.
We're building up the pressure. 80 PSI.
Or
110.
125.
Clear!
Go, let's go. Ready?
Three.
Come on, go! One.
That's fantastic!
Oh, did you see that? Did you feel? You didn't feel? I felt that. I felt that in my chest, in my loins, as that second canister just released its load. Down the track I went. I've now established a benchmark. Let's put some tape down here.
My rocket car travelled an amazing 27 metres and 83 centimetres. That's around 27 metres further than my last attempt. But my new distance record didn't look like standing for very long. You see, some Gadget Show viewers took our request for help very seriously and actually built water rocket cars of their own. Ladies and gentlemen, we have two challenges. The first is built by Sam, Gabriel, George and their teacher from Kingston Grammar School. The second is built by these boffins from, wait for it, the National Physical Laboratory. And both will be piloted by me. So first to go is the one built by the Kingston boys. This gorgeous ultralight machine uses 80 plastic bottles pressurised to 80 pounds per square inch. Despite dumping all the water in one go, the narrowness of the jets meant I had a good 10 seconds of thrust.
Oh, guys, is that all right? See, that's very interesting, you see. No drama, just a nice, even power all that way. All this weight, and it kept on going.
So how far did it keep on going for?
49 metres, 42 centimetres.
Yeah! Come on!
Well done!
Next up, the beautiful machine built by the brain boxes from NPL.
OK, guys, we're ready.
Having released half the water to get off the line, I then had two further stages to add thrust each time I slowed down. The NPL team's machine stores the pressurised air and water in separate bottles. Air at the front, water at the back. This prevents leakage, which should increase thrust. Much more sedate than my machine, but remember, this was all about who went furthest.
The National Physics Laboratory may well have done it, but it's going to be very close.
Get that red tape down there.
51 metres, 42 centimetres. Fantastic. The physics boys have it.
Hey, awesome. It worked.
No, absolutely brilliant. But of course, it was all down to the fact that you all got involved. The Gadget Show viewers, all those emails.